Okay, so we have been asked to grant 3 minutes each for summarizing the seminar today. And I will therefore draw attention to three main opportunities in the High North that have been referred to by all the speakers at the seminar today. And I will try to use 1 minute on each key point. The first key opportunity in the High North that I will discuss during the seminar is value creation and business development in the High North. The petroleum industry is the main driver for economic activities in the High North and has an important role for meeting the increasing demand for energy resources in the world, but also for growth and development of regions in the High North. The fishery industry is also an important driver for value creation and have an important role for feeding the world population, but also to employ people in High North regions. Because of all these opportunities for value creation and business development, the High North region is of strategic priority in foreign policy of Arctic countries. And both Norway and Russia have created a High North strategy. Because of the Arctic countries' interest and emphasis on the High North, it creates opportunities for international cooperation between Arctic countries and observers. In this manner, the second key opportunity in the High North is international cooperation. Through cooperation between Arctic countries, we can learn from each other and transfer technology and know-how for generating value creation and business development. International cooperation also creates insight to different Arctic countries' geopolitical and managerial approaches in the High North, and may even generate a common understanding and approach for developing the High North. When international cooperation becomes an opportunity for value creation and business development, aspects of governance in the High North becomes of importance. Understanding existing regulatory regimes and developing new regimes provide a third opportunity in the High North to develop an international regular framework. International regulatory regimes in the High North will ensure stability and predictability and can ensure a common approach to a sustainable development of the High North. And with this in mind, I can repeat the phrase that we are all doomed to cooperate in the High North.
And what I would like to add is that cooperation is a team game. And maybe one of the best team building practices is planning future jointly, together. When we come together and we think about what we want to achieve, where we want to arrive, and we do it on equal basis, and within common and legal, legitimate, regulated framework, which is named governance. So this framework has to be legal and legitimate, which means that it should not be just imposed, but all participants should benefit from cooperation. They should trust each other and they should be convinced that they arrive to where they want together.
That's a lot.